Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Game of Thrones. My name is Necroxis. Last time, everybody hated us, and everyone was being a douchebag, and I had tons of technical problems. So let's continue on and see what happens next. I believe we're going back to Essos. Yep.
This looks like the place.
This is definitely the place.
So, who are we dealing with exactly?
Pit fighters. Two go in, one comes out, day after day. No rules, but kill.
Sounds good.
Anyone who can survive that is capable of anything. They're crazed savages. But one pit fighter is worth any 10 sellswords.
All right, let's buy them then.
If you can convince them to fight for you.
I got gold.
And that's not going to be easy.
I can pay them.
Don't expect to charm them or reason with them.
I've got enough gold to buy them all.
I'd be careful flaunting it.
Well, let's help our family, because everyone else is getting screwed over. So hopefully these guys... That dog has a hand in its mouth. That dog has a hand in its mouth! And there are a bunch of heads on the dais behind that banner.
Must make you feel pretty good, seeing the masters overthrown.
They're not gone. They're just on their knees. And when they get back to their feet, they'll be more dangerous than ever.
Alright, if you say so. Pretty sure that's not an alive person right there. Okay.
You did what?
Oh, alright. Well.
Trust me, you don't want to get involved, Bishop.
I'm pretty sure even if I wanted to get involved, he's 5 stabs dead already, so... There goes that guy. Bunch of heads, that's nice. And a bunch of bodies.
The servants and guards of his house. They killed them all.
Why? Some of these must have been slaves, too.
Because they felt like it.
Because they're clearly fucking insane, Asher. That's probably why. Bunch of heads, let's look.
Your friends have been busy.
Let's hope our heads don't end up here.
Okay. That is... Is that person alive or dead? They're moving very slightly. He's alive! Wow, to my surprise. Oh, okay. That's a big boy.
Oh, one last thing. They're not fond of strangers. Or anyone who shows weakness.
I'll take the lead.
Or fear.
I'm not going to show weakness.
Oh, after you then.
Well, if it isn't Beskar, the fucking basilisk.
We just want to talk to Amaya.
You don't want to be in here, little man. You best go back the way you came before I decide to eat you.
Gotta show strength.
I'll start with your eyeballs.
You're fat enough already.
You sure you have room for me? You seem pretty well fed already.
My master only ever fed me when I won. I won a lot. Now, you've got to the count of three to turn around and walk.
No, gotta show strength. Hit him, punch him.
One.
Headbutt. Alright, combat time. No? Alright.
I like this one.
Yeah, I've impressed the beast.
Company.
Alright.
Is that a pit?
Yeah, some masters couldn't get enough of the fighting, so they built their own private pits, where things could get really nasty.
Okay. Let's go then. Move aside! I'm gonna get pushed into the pit, aren't I? That guy's dead. Oh, is Amaya a badass black lady?
Keep your cock in your pants, little brother. She's likely to chop it off.
Oh, yeah, she is. She looks awesome.
Well, hello there.
Not many people get past the beast. You must need something very badly. So, out with it.
I've come with an offer.
Before I decide not to let you leave.
I've come with an offer. I think it's one that'll interest you and your men.
If you wanted my interest, you wouldn't have shown up with her. Amaya, please. Please what? I had a friend once, the Basilisk, but she died a long time ago.
I earned my freedom.
You walked out on me. On all of us. Fighting side by side, we were goddesses of the pits. But when you're born trash, I guess you can't.
Oh, fuck that. Don't mess with Beska. Deal with me.
You have a problem with her. Deal with me.
Beska's my boo.
So, what is it that you want? Why shouldn't we rip you to pieces and feed you to the beast?
Because we got money?
My patience wears thin.
Oh, my enemies are worse than the masters.
My enemies in Westeros are powerful and bloodthirsty. Worse than your masters ever were.
That's true.
I need fearless soldiers to crush them.
You think we sell swords? We don't fight other people's wars. We are pit fighters. Artists who paint in blood.
That was yesterday. Fighting pits have been closed.
You're all free now. Free to do what you want.
Don't you see that?
Yes, we are free. Why would we follow another?
For blood and honor. Lokhtar Ogar. The thrill of war.
Anyone ever again?
You all excel at combat, but you know nothing until you've tasted the thrill of war. Waves of
men. Just telling them what they want to hear at this point.
Blood and steel. In Westeros, they sing of our great warriors for thousands of years.
Amaya, trust me. He's got enough gold for all of you.
You want to lead pit fighters? You have to earn their respect.
Oh, boy.
We don't know who you are until we see you.
All right, am I gonna fight the beast? Let's go! Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go.
You're gonna have to show them you can fight.
All right. Who?
Show me your best. Oh, no! They're gonna make me fight Beska.
Who's the best you've got?
Maybe. No, I don't want to fight her.
His name is Bloodsong. He's vicious, fearless, and fast.
He's also the only Asian in Westeros. Or Essos.
Take a good look there.
He's the man who's going to kill your boy.
Eh, I thought worse. And what do they call that? That scary one with the two axes and the skull tattoo back in Lys. What was it? Pestilence? Plague?
The Scourge.
Right. The Scourge. Anyway, he's dead. Well, suppose I better get this over with.
So what are you supposed to be? With your little axe and your pretty blonde beard? I'd sooner bend you over to fuck than fight you.
Thanks for noticing the beard.
What, are there Asians in Westeros?
Let's see how you die.
I can't recall a single, like, Asian-looking person in the entire series.
If I die in there...
I'm just saying... That's really weird.
You have a dying wish? This ought to be good.
Kill Bloodsong for me?
Will you at least kill Bloodsong?
No. I'll use your queen's gold to get as far away from here as possible.
Oh, fine, Beska. Fuck.
Hey! I need those!
You'll fight with the weapons we give you.
Okay. That is a headless man.
You all see this cockless Westerosi? He's come to order us to battle, like our masters did. I kill no man because another orders me to. I kill a man because it pleases me.
I kill to live.
Let me show you how we dance in Marine.
That's lovely. You know why I kill a man? So he's dead and I'm alive. Let's get this over with.
Choose a weapon and try not to die. Only one of you leaves the pit alive.
All right.
May the best fighter win.
The best would be me.
Here, use this.
This one. Oh, shit. It's a crazy-ass mace with spikes on it.
Ready your ears for the song of blood.
Don't know what the fuck that means, but I'm gonna have to repeat.
I don't know what the fuck that means. What? I'd block that.
Would it help if I stood still?
Maybe.
Come on, pretty
get him. Get him! Yeah! Hit him while he's down! Again!
Son of a whore!
What's next? Spike claws!
See if you're still smiling after I break your face!
Surprised you can lift it!
Dodge that shit! Yeah! Get the legs! E! Q! E! Oh yeah, kicking ass!
Damn.
Oh, it broke.
Last chance, Westeros!
Oh, it's like a sword that the Unsullied use. Those crazy, like, crescent swords.
You won't be so lucky this time!
What does this bitch think he is? Oberyn?
But that wasn't luck.
Oh, I'm gonna kill this asshole.
Are you ready, Westerosi?
Shut up and die.
This is gonna hurt.
Get him.
Yours would be a beautiful death. Isn't that something you'd like to
say? Stab him now.
Hear that, boy? We cannot let the crowd go wanting.
I think I can, actually.
Yeah. You're dead now, bitch. Q! E! Gameplay! Ah, shit! Q! E! This is tense!
Ready! Westerosi! Don't hold back!
Don't intend to!
Look at this terrified boy! He fears his end!
Oh, shut up! Uh-oh. Wow. Oh, God. Q! Ah, damn. Have I won yet? Come on. Yeah! Get him again! Fuck yeah! Just kill him, Asher. We won already. Yeah, this is his dumb rules. They're dumb rules, so kill him.
Your stupid game. Your stupid rules.
Yep. Nice. We've impressed him. Woo-hoo!
Your old champion is gone. As are your old masters. You can stay here in Marine with nothing, or you can come with me. I chose you for a reason.
You are true warriors.
You're true warriors. Warriors I admire and respect.
Okay, game, don't break on me now. No, stop that shit.
You deserve better than this. You deserve more than to die.
You will have glory and gold.
Entertainment. Fight with me, and you will have glory and gold.
If you've got the balls to follow me, we will set sail at dawn. And to those too craven to join me, to hell with you.
What a weird way to end that. Also, I was just completely telling all of them what they wanted to hear. I really don't necessarily believe any of that. Oh, I forgot about this. Whites!
I knew them!
What are those things? Oh, God! Over here! Over here!
They're whites. They're Zambos! Kill them! Q! Get her! No! Chop her head off! Can't you kill whites chopping them their heads off? I don't remember. I think you can. I know fire works. Why don't we get fire?
Anything can be killed.
Oh, Finn's dead. He's dead. I'm convinced Finn's about to die. Yep, there he goes. He's dead. Again! I'm sorry, Finn. Chop her head off. Get fire. We had a fire pit. Oh, shit. Yeah, see, why didn't we do that? Oh, Finn's definitely dead. I knew he was gonna die when you had the choice to take him or not. That's what Telltale always does.
Why won't they die?
We need fire! It's the only way!
Fire!
Fucking
hell! This bitch doesn't die yet. Get her in the leg! No! Oh yeah, good. I thought it registered in the chest. Oh, this... Was that the one whose head just got chopped off? Get the fire. Get her! Yeah! I thought you could kill them by chopping their heads off. I guess not. I know fire works. Dragon fire, of course, works. Valyrian steel obviously works.
Where's Finn?
He was over there.
He's dead. He's probably a white, actually. We should burn his body if he's not. Oh, he's dead. What a waste of a character.
Finn.
Let's burn him. Oh, fuck. Never mind. Run.
They're everywhere.
We make for the North Grove. We need to stick together.
Oh, so this is how they're going to do it. This is how they're going to make him change their mind and go north. All right.
No! I hope you're right about this, Gared.
I hope you're right about the thing you have no idea about. No, poor Finn. Like I said, I knew he'd be dead the second the Telltale had the option of bringing him or not. They always do that. They did that in Walking Dead. I don't want to spoil Walking Dead, but they do it multiple times in Walking Dead. I haven't played Wolf Among Us yet. I still want to do that on this channel, but I hear that also happens there. And now Mira's going to get arrested or some shit. Oh, fuck.
Your Grace.
Uh-oh.
You're familiar with my brother's chambers, aren't you? Certainly you've been here before. You looked rather confused when you came in. As if you didn't know where you were.
Ah, what are you suggesting?
I don't know what you mean, Your Grace.
I'm told you know these chambers as well as anyone.
Oh my god.
You're quite the curiosity, aren't you? You profess to be loyal to the crown, yet... You're not very loyal to Lady Marjorie.
Have I displeased you, Your Grace?
I've heard things. I understand you've been quite busy.
I'm so stressed out right now by this conversation.
Tell me, do you consider yourself an honest, loyal handmaiden? One can never tell with you northern girls.
Oh my god, I hate the... I love and hate the Cersei conversations. I never know what to say. Listen. At this point, I think the game is just making Cersei, like, omnipotent. Because she's, you know, she... you know, in the lore of A Song of Ice and Fire, she has, like, a lot of spies and stuff, but I didn't think anyone... How would anybody know that I was in Tyrion's chambers? I guess somebody might have saw. Or maybe Tom. Where's Tom? We haven't seen him in this episode. Maybe he's actually loyal to Cersei. But I don't know what to say.
Assuming an honest person exists...
I'll be honest. I done what I had to do.
It hasn't been easy, Your Grace. But I've done what I've needed to do.
Haven't we all? I've done my best to keep an open mind about people like you.
That's a lie.
Lucan tells me you invited yourself to Tommen's coronation party. How exactly did that happen? It can't have been easy.
I did what I had to do.
I do what's necessary, Your Grace.
Including using another girl to talk your way in.
Yeah, fuck Sarah, I don't care about her anymore.
You're not above using people to get what you want. Good.
That's true. Oh, okay.
Why would you be so reckless as to risk your neck for what?
I'm just going to be honest with her, because she apparently knows everything already anyway.
Considering the consequences.
I did it for my family.
My family is still very much at risk, Your Grace. It was crucial I attend.
Your family. Sometimes that's a convenient lie we tell ourselves.
Yeah, but in this case it's not, actually.
When I suspect your issue with Lord Andros played a part in it. You've been such a busy little handmaiden. I assume Lady Marjorie knew nothing of this.
No, Your Grace.
This wasn't the first time you've hidden the truth from her. You've no qualms about lying to her, have you?
Oh my God, what do I say?
Your secret is safe with
me. Oh, I don't believe that for a second. I have to really think out all of these things. Only when necessary.
Only when I must, Your Grace.
I think we both know it's more often than that.
I impressed Cersei, yay!
Perhaps I mistook your northern stubbornness for ignorance, but now I see there's more to you. You're a cunning girl, and perhaps you can help me.
Your Grace?
Quite friendly with my brother.
Oh,
Tyrion.
No.
I need you to speak with him before the trial begins. I want to know who he intends to call as a witness on his behalf. Consider it a favor to the crown. For which we will all.
I'll try!
I guess I could, Your Grace.
It won't be easy. Tyrion is devious. You'll have to hide your intentions, otherwise he'll tell you.
He's gonna know, like, right away!
You may prove to be a useful...
He knows everything Cersei's doing.
Assuming you do as you're told. In return, I'll take care of your problem with Lord Andros.
What problem?
Thank you, Your Grace.
She gonna, like, kill him?
I never liked the man anyway.
Is she gonna, like, get rid of him for me?
And I doubt anyone will miss him.
That's really what that sounds like. She's gonna kill him for me. If that's the case, I might have to lie... to Tyrion. But I like Tyrion. Also, I'm pretty sure he's gonna realize immediately that I was sent by Cersei, because he's smart.
You think we hired this boat for nothing?
No, I don't know. That was a rousing speech you gave, little brother. But who knows how much they heard.
They say your homeland is fat and prosperous. An orchard ripe for plucking.
We'll take what we want and kill anyone.
We need to win first.
Stands in our way.
There's no spoils without victory.
Don't worry about
that. I want to see a Maya fight.
Victory is all
she
we
looks
know.
Awesome.
I'll show them their beds.
Vesco wasn't exaggerating.
Malcolm, you're here.
And you found your soldiers.
Yep, we can go and save everyone.
I'll be glad of your return. You came through for them. Just as I knew you would.
Roderick probably won't like that we have sellswords.
What should I tell Roderick? Tell him what I do. I do for our house. Daenerys will eventually return to Westeros.
I doubt that, Evan.
If
it's
I can,
happen.
I'd like to help her reclaim the Iron Throne. Imagine what an ally she'd be to House Forrester if she succeeds.
It's never gonna happen.
Living here has made a better man of you, nephew.
Thank you for your guidance.
Thank you, Uncle.
I wouldn't be doing this if it wasn't for you. You've guided me well.
You are your father's son, Asher. For all your differences, he would be proud. I'll send a raven ahead to Ironwrath to let Roderick know you sail for Westeros.
Listen, I know I said I didn't think Asher would get back to Westeros.
My thoughts will be with you in the fight to come.
But I really don't think Daenerys is going back to Westeros.
Asher. Iron from ice.
Don't you mean fire and blood? Oh, I should say that, but...
Iron from ice.
Casting off!
It feels like we're getting to the end of this already. It hasn't been long.
Take this. It'll help loosen his tongue. But be careful. He's a tricky little bastard.
Get him drunk! Get drunk, get drunk.
If he figures out who sent you, he'll tell you nothing.
He's gonna know.
I'll be listening to every word you say.
Oh my god. This is easily the most stressful. These are always the most stressful parts of this game.
Oh, I ask for brawn, they send me a handmaiden. Well, you're here. You might as well come in. Let me guess. Your family is in grave danger, and you've come seeking my help? Not that I'd be of much use to you.
I come only as a friend!
As you can see, I'm at a bit of a disadvantage.
I thought we were friends, Lord Tyrion.
I thought so as well. Yet, here you are. You brought wine. How thoughtful of you.
Yep.
And you didn't even have to hide.
Is that shit poison? Oh.
Doesn't smell poison.
Guess not.
Poisoned?
Cersei would love nothing more than to save herself the trouble of a trial. You don't expect me to drink alone, do you? They never let anyone...
Get drunk, get crunk, get nasty!
I suppose I'll have just a little.
Ah, true girl of the North.
My Mira is a fucking alcoholic.
Some things are worth dying for. So, why are you here?
Oh, no!
It's rather unusual.
I was worried about you?
I've been worried about you, Lord Tyrion.
Oh, have you? You may be the only person in all of King's Landing.
I really don't
want
to work for Cersei, but I...
You and Podrick. I have to admit, I've always admired your honesty, but I suspect there's more to you than one might imagine. This is all a ruse, isn't it?
No, he already knows.
Sorry.
He already knows.
You're coming here.
He already knows.
We both know you have an ulterior motive.
Oh, boy.
You've come to set me free.
Oh.
It's the perfect plan.
let's keep being jokey whenever you're ready.
I'm ready whenever you are.
I doubt we'd get very far.
Let's get more drunk. Come on!
So, tell me. Cersei sent you.
Well.
Didn't she? I know I'm not wrong.
He knows! He knows already! I don't even think I could convince him otherwise. She left me no choice. Fuck it. Honesty time.
The truth, Mira.
She left me no choice.
She never does. Least you had the courage to tell
me. I don't even
think
she would honor my deal anyway.
Not to run your mouth. Stupid girl.
I owe him the truth.
You're acting a fool.
I owe him the truth.
Him? He's nothing now.
I'm still a Lannister. And I know plenty of men who'd happily slit your throat. Now, give us a moment. We're not done talking.
Oh, Mira's dead. Mira's dead. I now have directly...
What did my sister expect you would
screwed
learn?
Screwed Cersei.
Who will testify on your behalf?
She's using you.
Yep.
And will continue to do so.
I can't refuse... I really can't refuse her.
It's not as if I could refuse her.
Cersei is not someone to be trifled with. And what would Lady Marjorie make of your new friendship with my sister? I doubt she'd be pleased.
I don't care what she thinks, that's not true. She'll never find out, that's also not true. She'll understand, I don't think so. She already hates me anyway, so I'll just say that.
Assuming she doesn't dismiss you immediately.
Lady Marjorie will understand. Cersei left me no choice.
Let's hope she understands. because absent her protection, you're in a very precarious
position. I
haven't
had that in a while, it seems like.
What should I tell Cersei?
She knows the answer better than anyone. No one will testify for me. She's already seen to
so
that.
So what, was this a test?
That is the truth of it.
Thank you for being honest.
That it will help
I'm
you.
Fucked anyway.
I appreciate your honesty, Lord Tyrion.
And I yours, Lady Mira. Although I doubt my sister will.
Enough of this nonsense! You're wasting my time! Out! Now!
I wish you well, Lady Mira. Be careful who you trust.
Peter Dinklage sounds like he's doing a much better job as a voice actor now. Is this the first time he's done it? I think it is, actually. A voice acted in a game. And then, like, the first episode, he sounded really... Was it the first or second when he first shows up? He sounded really stilted. Oh, my!
Must you leave?
Sorry. Didn't mean to wake you.
You didn't sleep, did you?
Neither did you.
Oh!
We haven't slept much at all these last few weeks.
Oh, has there been a time skip?
I hope you don't have any regrets. About this. About us.
Oh, about us? No, of course not.
I've never felt more certain about anything.
I'm glad. I wasn't sure if you... With all that's happened. What will we do now? Now that we're... What we are.
We're married, I guess.
We'll be married. And no one will be able to keep us apart. Not Griff. Not his father. Not Ramsay Snow.
I was hoping you'd say that. Roderick?
Oh.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were alone. Good morning, Talia. Hello, Elena. I didn't realize you two were...
It's
all
right.
I didn't realize she was...
It's all right, Talia. Come in.
I really am sorry.
It's like she's wasted.
It's just, this is urgent, Roderick. And... It's all right. I can go. You two need to speak. I'll see you soon.
She just leaves butt-ass naked. I mean, she has a blanket, but still. Or is that supposed to be her dress? I don't know.
All right, then. I'm listening.
Last night, I couldn't... I was having nightmares. So I...
Go on, Talia.
I went back there.
Oh, God. What's going to happen now?
To the grove. And someone was there.
Oh, the traitor!
Look.
I forgot! Uh-oh. Are we going to find out who the traitor is?
This is a report. How many fighting men we have? Where Griff and the White Hill Garrison are being held?
It even talks about Elena.
I know. It's everything.
All right, who did it?
I couldn't believe
it. What did you see?
You said you saw someone. Who?
Someone we trusted.
Okay.
Talia, I need to know who it was.
He's like family, Roderick.
Oh, he. So it's,
but it doesn't
it's
matter.
It's not the mom.
He's a traitor. He endangered our house.
Who is it?
You have to deal with him like you would any other man. I'm sure he had his reasons.
Just tell me.
It's your duty to tell me. And mine to pass judgment.
So it's got
to
be either Roderick...
Just promise me you'll kill him, Roderick.
Duncan.
Anyone who would
Roiland,
betray us like this deserves to die.
Or the Maester?
I'm asking you as your
oh,
sister...
Oh yeah, we're executing him. This is the North.
I give you my word, Talia. Traitor will get what
he deserves. This traitor's getting killed. I don't care who it is.
Now, tell me.
Come with me.
The only person I probably He's would not have executed court. Is if it was the mother, or for some reason Talia herself. Although I don't know why it ever would have been her, but... The other three, they're dead. I don't care who it is, but they're getting executed. I really hope it's not the person that Ethan didn't pick, because that's fucking... That would be so obvious. Also, the Maester would be obvious too, so I don't know. Maybe it's the person you did pick. Oh, that'd be a mindfuck.
Go get the guards.
That actually would be really interesting if it's the person you did pick for Sentinel. Who is that? Is that the Maester? It's Sir Roiland! Son of a bitch!
My lord, you scared the bloody daylights.
It's the person I didn't pick. Boo.
What's that? You tell me.
You don't scare me, Roderick. I've known you since you were a boy. You sold your loyalty like some whore in the street.
My loyalty has always been to this house, but you've been too damn blind to see it.
Now, what I didn't see is that you were a traitor.
You pushed me to this, Roderick. You brought it upon yourself.
Don't make excuses.
Don't you dare start making excuses.
Excuses? Are you that naive? Look at you, Roderick. You're weak. You're weak, just like Ethan.
This doesn't even make sense.
Taking Duncan his sentinel.
Ethan was a boy.
Ethan was a fool. And you've been making fool choices too, since the day you crawled off that corpse cart. Kissing Lud's ring, when you knew we had to show strength. Letting Griff force you to the ground, without a shred of dignity. Going to High Point without any soldiers, despite my every warning. Hell, you even managed to get Arthur killed!
Enough, Roiland!
It was Ramsay Snow, you bitch.
You've had every opportunity to save this family, but you've squandered them all. Your father was
This really
ashamed.
Doesn't make any sense. Yeah, so you turn traitor? What the fuck?
It's the bloody truth.
So you turn your cloak? That's your answer?
I'm not gonna stand by and watch you destroy this family!
So I'll do it faster? This does not make
You're
any sense!
You're driving House Forrester the way of the Starks.
The only thing that matters is that you swore an oath to Owen.
I swore to your father. I'd swear to Asher if he were here. But you're a cripple who can barely hold a sword. Asher knows how to act.
Asher would kill this guy.
Asher would cut your traitor heart out.
Oh, I don't doubt it. He has more balls than you
oh,
ever
Oh, he is totally dead.
Roderick, it's Griff. He's gone.
What?
Somebody set him free. Was this your doing?
They were going to ambush you at the trade. I just saved your life.
You set Griff free!
Roiland, how could you?
This was his doing.
None of this makes any sense, Telltale. The fucking story, this makes no sense. So he's upset that...
Just sentence me and be
So he's upset that Roderick made bad decisions and he cares about the family so he betrays them?
Roderick,
fuck this guy.
Promised.
He's dead.
Kill
I'm
me.
Killing him. Easiest choice I've made this whole game. Too. Fuck him. Also, fuck Telltale. This makes no sense.
It was the right thing.
So they were going to ambush us
what
at the trade?
Said. We have to warn Asher.
Wait, why?
We can't, not if he's at sea.
My lord, what do we do?
Wait, what? So, I'm confused. He made it seem like they were going to ambush him at the trade for Ryan for Griff, which is what we agreed upon at the last episode. But then they act like his threat was talking about Asher, even though there was no trade happening where Asher is. Because first of all, he's not even here. We got to bring him home. He has the soldiers.
Prepare the horses.
We're gonna defend my brother.
Oh shit, we don't need any... I guess he doesn't need that anymore. They did say that he would be healed soon enough. I think the Maester said that in the second episode. Where is him, by the way? I haven't seen him either. Or, like I said already, Tom the Coldboy. There's like missing a pretty important characters.
Smell that. We're almost there, Beskar. Let's have a look.
I was gonna say, I don't know how they're so close already, but I guess...
Save your lovemaking for below deck.
Was there an employee...
They listen to you.
There was an employee time skip, right?
Barely.
When Elena...
What happens if your lord brother decides he's the one in charge once we're at Ironman?
Said something about...
Do you expect them to follow his orders? Or will it be you commanding them? They don't know him.
The answer to me.
A lord sounds an awful lot like a master.
Doesn't matter if Roderick's lord of our house. These are my soldiers to lead.
Huh? You may want to start by telling them your brother's not to be harmed. He hasn't had a chance to win them over like you have.
Point taken.
Oh, they're already there. Where is that? That's not Ironwrath. Ironwrath's not on the sea. Is that White Harbor?
That's odd. Port's quiet. No,
I don't think we've seen White Harbor in the show.
Hardly any ships.
Or the boats,
maybe they're
really.
All off fighting one of your king's wars.
Could be.
Or could be we'll have a fight on our hands. I'll let the others know.
I don't understand what's happening anymore. So is there going to be an ambush here? Even though they said there was going to be an ambush
at
the trade. Or was the trade supposed to happen here? I just don't remember that. Did they ever say the trade was happening at White Harbor? Are we at White Harbor? That's the only harbor that I know from the lore. Besides King's Landing is also a harbor, but...
So, this is Westeros.
Ugly. And small.
Fucking freezing, too.
I said you'd be paid. I never said you'd be warm.
Winter is coming and all of that. Hey, it's everybody. I cannot believe Asher actually made it back. Call me surprised.
Thank the gods you made it back.
Wait, I'm confused. I've played a point of view character of both of these characters. So who am I right now? I'm Asher, right? You've looked better.
You've looked better? We've no time for small talk, brother.
So...
Hope you're
Oh, no! Come to a realization. As I was saying that, I've played both of these characters as a point of view character, and now they're together. One of them's dying.
Or something planned.
They're gonna make me pick which one to kill! That's what it is. I'm convinced.
Been stuck on a boat for weeks.
Oh, no! That's so obvious. I can see it from a mile away. Also, that guy's a traitor. Yep, here we go. Come on, the beast. Open up the gate.
Get that gate open.
Asher, no.
Go, big guy, go.
It's been a while since I killed any White Hills.
Cute! Yeah! Get fucked, get wrecked. Oh no, the beast!
Out of my way.
I liked him. Oh, well, he's not dead yet.
It won't go farther!
Oh, that fucking bearded guy. No, the beast!
Asher, you have to get out of there!
Looks like it's up to us.
Ah, shit.
Asher! Raise the gate.
Oh my god,
Doors outnumbered. Oh shit.
They're gonna make one of them stay behind. God. Who do I pick? What does each one of them bring? Asher has the mercenaries. They made it a point to say that if Asher's dead, or that if he wasn't leading them, they would not follow Roderick. Asher also has Beska. Beska would probably not follow Roderick. She'd probably just peace out, and I like Beska a lot. Roderick has what? He has the forces of the... But if Roderick died, Asher would just become Lord. So, he would still become the Lord of the Forces. But what is Roderick... Am I not for thinking of something that Roderick brings that Asher doesn't? Because right now it seems like Asher is the more obvious choice to pick. other than I like Roderick as a character, I like Asher too. I don't know if I like one more than the other, but I think I have to go with Asher. Roderick's also like permanently crippled, or at least I thought he was. I guess they made it a point to show that Asher got shot in like the leg, but I think I gotta go with Asher just based on like tactical, like intelligence. Based, he has more forces. He has Beska, who's also a really good fighter. Roderick doesn't have much.
Asher, come on! Don't you dare leave me, Asher!
No.
I came all this way.
You must hurry.
Roderick has to stay behind.
Let me save your life and our house. Iron from ice, bro.
Oh no!
Iron from
Roderick
ice.
Has the Glenmores. Oh, and Elena. Oh shit. Is that still more better though?
Hold them
I don't know.
But my lord, you
Asher
can't.
Asher is your new lord.
Yes, my lord.
Roderick, go.
Alright, let's go out in a blaze of glory! Fuck that guy! Let's get Griff at least, come on. We're making our way to Griff. Get... Oh, shit. Get Griff. Oh! Bearded man! Get this guy! This one! Q! Kill them all! Yeah, Roderick! One last hurrah. Oh my god, right in the neck. I don't know what I'm queuing for, but... Oh, we are killing every Whitehall that we can next episode. That's the end, isn't it? Oh, no! Alright. This one was obvious. I really felt like even if I went along the entire thing, Cersei was not going to help me. Because she's fucking Cersei! Executed the traitor. No question. That didn't make any sense, and he was dead anyway. Right. Okay, so Elena's going to be like, fuck this, I'm out, and leave. But the Glenmores, we've never even seen, like, their forces. They've made it a point to be like, we need to ally with them, because they have an army. But we know that her dad, the Glenmore Lord, was a little bitch, and he was kowtowing to Whitehill. Arthur's dead. Ramsay ordered all of Arthur's forces back. Elena's a cool character, but she doesn't bring anything to, like, the war effort. I still feel like I made the right choice. Oh my god. I had a lot of problems with this episode. First of all, starting from the beginning, Daenerys just lying to us? That's totally out of character for her. She flat out said that she would give us her forces if we helped her take Meereen. I could understand if I let Beska kill whatever his name was. And then she would be like, no way, I'm not going to give him to you. But I stopped her. That didn't make any sense. I felt like that choice of letting Beska kill him or not didn't matter at all. That completely invalidated my choice, in my opinion. Everybody hating me. Sarah, I was fucking good to her the entire game. And she still decides to abandon me, I guess. So it feels like all of the things I've done protecting her didn't matter for nothing. Marjorie just hates me. There's no way to make Marjorie not hate you, apparently. That choice at the end I saw coming. You guys saw me come to that realization before it happened. The traitor thing is the dumbest part. First of all, the logic behind the traitor betraying the family makes no sense. None of what Roiland said made any sense. I was trying to explain it as the dialogue was happening, but I didn't want to talk over all the dialogue. I did that enough already. But he's basically like, I've always wanted to protect his family, and I feel like your choices are bad, so then I'm going to go be a traitor for the people that are trying to kill you? That didn't make any sense. That didn't fucking make any sense. I wonder, Maybe is it always Roiland? It's got to be the guy that Ethan didn't pick. So that means it's Duncan if you picked Roiland. I wonder what Duncan says. So that was fucking stupid. I don't know how they're going to end the next episode without killing the Sentinel and the brother that you picked. Because if they want this game to go on to season 2, which they fucking do, Telltale has never once in its existence let a character who you could pick to die be really important, like, for a long time. They might be important for the next episode, but I don't see how they can continue on season 2 without killing, for me, it would be Duncan, because he's the guy that survived, and Asher. I don't see how... I am convinced both of those characters are dead next episode, based on Telltale and how they're kind of lazy in their development. But I don't know. Let me know what you guys thought all about this episode in the comments below. In my opinion, this was easily the worst episode so far. Almost all of the characters who were not played by me were just fucking ridiculously stupid for no apparent reason. Daenerys lying to Asher is completely out of character for Daenerys Targaryen. Completely out of character for Daenerys. In fact, she's shown to be an honorable person. She might, like, manipulate things a little bit, like when she acquired the Unsullied, but she didn't lie. That's her whole thing. She's not a liar. She's not like Littlefinger or Mira, I guess, or my Mira, the way I made her. I don't know, man. I didn't like any of the narrative choices they made this episode. My enthusiasm for the final episode is still there. I'm just kind of not sure if it's going to be good or not at this point. So, I don't know, guys. Let me know what you thought about all this in the comments below. But until next time, I'll see you for the finale in another, 3 months. But, yeah, stay awesome, and farewell. Also, I forgot to even mention, Garrett's stuff was fucking stupid. Like, I didn't care about any of that. Finn dying, I saw coming from a mile away. And finally, bringing Ramsay Snow back at the end of the last episode and the beginning of this one was fucking stupid. It felt like they couldn't think of a way to bring more drama into the plot. So they brought back Ramsay Snow to do his whatever shit. And I like Ramsay Snow as a character. But in this, it was so dumb because they make Roderick be like, for a long time, really, for like the entire game so far, they've been like, we're gonna get the Boltons, we're gonna get revenge. You're not. Telltale, you have to realize people who play this game either watch the movie or watch the show, which is probably more likely, or also read the books, like I've done both. Ramsay Snow is alive in both of those, and that takes place, that thus far the end of both of those has taken place after this game. And so he's going to survive. There's no way you can kill Ramsay Snow. So what? Stop. Stop saying you're going to get revenge. That's such a shallow plot device. That's not going to happen with 100% certainty. It's not going to happen. So they have to stop doing that. That's it. I forgot a couple thoughts I wanted to bring in there, so, yeah. Bum, bum, ba-da-dum, dum, ba-da-dum, dum, da-da-dum, dum, da-da-dum, dum, da-da-dum, dum, da-da, ba-da-ba, ba, ba-da-ba, ba-da-boo, Game of Thrones, episode 5, only one left, only one left, only one left, only...